Jack Sparrow waited until the salesman had turned his back before he snatched four of the lively yellow little birds and shoved them into his coat pockets. He felt them peck at his fingers as he turned and began striding away from the market booth. They chirped and protested the abrupt change in their surroundings. He tried not to grimace as one particularly forceful thrust of a beak broke through the skin of his palm. "Oi! You, there! Where are you going?" the salesman called as he noticed that some form of thievery had just been conducted. "Get back here, bugger! Time to go, then." He took off at a sprint, dodging and weaving his way through the mingling citizens of Port Royal. A few protested in alarm at the man shoving between them, scolding him for being so reckless. He scoffed, but otherwise ignored them. What did they know anyway? As he slipped out of the crowd at the edge of the market, he slowed his pace to a walk once more. He could hear the chicks frantically chirping in his pockets, could feel their beaks and clawed feet tear at his hands in desperation. He was fairly certain he was bleeding a little, but he didn't mind much. It would be a minor inconvenience, nothing more. When he approached the docks, where his longboat awaited, he was cut short by a soldier of the Royal Navy. "You have got to be bloody joking." "I don't have time for this." The soldier frowned in puzzlement before he could say anything. "What's that noise?"
"How would I know?"
Jack questioned.
"It sounds like chickens."
The man's eyes lit up in clarity, then he turned on him in accusation. "Hands out of your pockets, sir." With a sigh, the pirate found that he had to obey. Wringed, bloodied hands slid from his coat pockets. He offered a sheepish grin as a chick poked a crimson-stained beak out into the light. "You didn't steal these chicks, did you?"
"Steal them? No. Why would I do that?"
"Then where did you get them?" the soldier inquired.
"They were lost." He improvised a lie.
"I was used taking them to my ship to feed them before I sought out an owner."
"Hmm. Very well."
The man stepped aside and waved him on.
"Pardon me for the interruption, sir. Go about your business. Don't forget to bandage those hands. You don't want them to get infected."
"I'll keep it in mind." Jack tipped his tricorn hat to the soldier in an appreciative gesture as he resumed his walk to the boat. He smiled to himself as he sat down in the longboat and grabbed the oars to row out to the Black Pearl. He shook his head, faintly amused. "These soldiers are all the same.